स्टूडेंट्स, द टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस टुडे इज नॉर्मल सब ग्रुप्स एंड क्वेश्चन ग्रुप्स। ए सब ग्रुप एच ऑफ जी इज कॉल्ड ए नॉर्मल सब ग्रुप ऑफ जी इफ एवरी लेफ्ट कोसेट ऑफ एच इन जी इज इक्वल टू द कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग राइट कोसेट ऑफ एच इन जी, दैट इज ए एच इज इक्वल टू एच ए फॉर ऑल एलिमेंट्स ऑफ जी ग्रुप जी। If the composition defined on G be addition, then H will be a normal subgroup of G if and only if A plus H is equal to HA for all elements A in G. When G is an abelian group, then every subgroup H of G is a normal subgroup because AH is equal to HA for all abelian groups. The subgroup containing only identity element and G itself of any group G are always normal subgroups of G. These are called trivial normal subgroups. If H is a normal subgroup of G, then we write it as A delta G. A subgroup H of G is called is a normal subgroup of G if and only if G H G inverse belongs to subgroup H for every H element of subgroup H and G element of group G. Let us firstly suppose that H be a normal subgroup of G. Then from the definition, G H is will be equal to H G for all G element of group G. Let small h be a element of subgroup H and G be a, an element of group G. Then G H belongs to GH and this is equal to HG. This means GH belongs to HG. GS belongs to HG. This means GH will be of the type H1G for H1 for some H1 in the subgroup H. By post multiplication by G inverse on both sides, we get G H G inverse is equal to H1, which but H1 belongs to capital H subgroup of subgroup H. This means G H G inverse belongs to H. Now we suppose that G is a subgroup of G, H be a subgroup of G such that G H G inverse belongs to H for all H in the subgroup H and G in the group G. Now we show that H is a normal subgroup, that is AH is equal to HA for all element A in G. Let A be an element of G group G, then by the given hypothesis from the we have supposed that GHG inverse belongs to H. This means A inverse also belongs to H subgroup H for all H element of subgroup H. Suppose that AH belongs to AH, left coset of H. This means AH will be equal to AH inverse A because we have taken H is equal to AH A inverse. This belongs to HA. This means AH also belongs to HA. That is AH is a subset of HA. Now again suppose that B be A equal to A inverse, be any element of G because A belongs to G. This means and G is a group and this means A inverse also belongs to G. Therefore B H B inverse also belongs to H because we have supposed that all the elements of type G H G inverse belongs to subgroup H. This means BH B inverse belongs to H. But BH B inverse is equal to, by putting the value of B, B is equal to A inverse H A inverse of A inverse is equal to A inverse H A. This element belongs to capital H, that is subgroup H. Let H A belongs to right coset of H in A, H in G, then H A will be equal to A A inverse H A by associative law, A inverse HA belongs to AH. This means HA belongs to right coset of HNA, left coset of H. This means right coset of H is a subset of left coset of H. By combining first and second, we have AH is equal to HA for all element A in group G. Hence, H is a normal subgroup of G. Now, see this theorem. Let H be a subgroup of G, then the following statements are equivalent. GH, G inverse belongs to subgroup H for all G in group G and H in H element of subgroup H. GH, G inverse is equal to H for all elements G in G and GH is equal, that is left coset of H in G is equal to right coset of H in G for all G in group G. Now, because this element GH, G inverse belongs to H for all G in group G and H in subgroup H, this means this element will be of the type H1, belongs to subgroup H. This was every element of this type belongs to H. This means GH, G inverse will be equal to H. Now, let us suppose that this is equal to H for all G in the group G. This means GH, G inverse into G is equal to right coset of H and G. That is, G, by applying the associative law, GH, GG inverse is equal to HG, that is GHE is equal to HG, that is GH is equal to HG. That is left coset of H and G is equal to right coset of H and G. Now suppose that left coset of H and G is equal to right coset of H and G. This means element of GH, left coset will be of the type GH, and also this is equal to HG and this will be equal to H1G for some H1 and H in the elements of subgroup H. That implies GH, G inverse belongs to is equal to H by post multiplication by G inverse. GH is equal to H1G, GH, G inverse is equal to H1G, G inverse, but this G, G inverse is equal to E, therefore GH, G inverse is equal to H1E, and H1E is equal to H1. This means G, G inverse is equal to H1 belongs to H. That implies GH, G inverse belongs to H for all G elements of G and H in subgroup H. Now in the next theorem, let H and K be two subgroup of G, then H is a normal subgroup of G, then HK is equal to KH is a subgroup of G, and if H and K are both normal subgroups, then HK is equal to KH is a normal subgroup of G. G is a group and we have given that H is a normal subgroup of G. We have to show that HK is equal to KH is also a subgroup of G. Let us suppose that B belongs to an element of K, then HB will be equal to BH because H is a normal subgroup of G. Here B belongs to G. Here B belongs to G. When element of any element of group G, then HB is equal to BH because H is a normal subgroup, therefore left and right cosets are equal. Also, K is also a normal subgroup of G, therefore B element also belongs to K. B element also belongs to K. This means HB is equal to BH for belongs to KH because B is also an element of K. This means HK is subset of KH. Similarly, BH is equal to HB belongs to HK for all element of B in K. that is BH belongs to HK, that is KH is a subgroup, subset of HK. Combining these two statements, HK is equal to KH. Now, suppose that H and K are both normal subgroup of G. By HK is equal to KH, we have already proved in the previous article, is a subgroup of G. Then we have to show that H is a normal subgroup of G. Let G be an element of group G, then GHK G inverse, from the definition of normal subgroup, GH G inverse G K G inverse, by using associative law, is equal to GGH GH G inverse G K G inverse. By using associative law, we get that GHK G inverse is equal to GH G inverse G K G inverse. This element also belongs to H because H is normal subgroup, and this is belongs to K. This means H and K are normal subgroups. Because any element of the type GH G inverse is equal to H and GK G inverse is equal to K, therefore H and K will be a normal subgroup. Hence H and K, HK is a normal subgroup of G. The center ZG of a group G is a normal subgroup of G. Because center of a group is defined as the set of all the elements of G such that X is equal to GX for all X in the group G. Clearly, ZG, center of group G, contains elements of G, therefore ZG is a subset of G clearly. Also, EX is an anti-element. EX is equal to XE for all X elements of G, and therefore E belongs to ZG, because from the definition of ZG, center of group, any element which show this property belongs to center of group. An anti-element E shows the property EX is equal to XE, therefore E is an element of center of group. This means center of group is not a empty set, it is a non-empty set, subset of G. Let us suppose that two elements A and B belongs to center of group G. Then from the definition, AX is equal to XA for all X in the elements of G, and BX is equal to XB. This means XB inverse is equal to B inverse X. Now, XAB inverse is equal to XAB inverse by applying associative law is equal to, now XA is equal to AX by again using associative law, AXB inverse B inverse will be equal to AB inverse X, that is AB inverse X, that is XAB inverse is equal to AB inverse X for all X in the element elements of G. This means AB inverse belongs to center of group G for all elements AB center of group G. So ZG is a subgroup of G from the definition of subgroup. Now we show that center of group is also a normal subgroup of G. Let H belongs to center of group G, and G belongs to group G, then GH G inverse is equal to GH G inverse HG G inverse H GG inverse GG inverse is equal to E is equal to H is equal to H. H belongs to ZG. This means GH G inverse belongs to ZG. Therefore, ZG at the center of group is a normal subgroup. Now, suppose that H be a subgroup of G. If X square belongs to H for all X elements of G, then prove that H is a normal subgroup of G. Let G be any element of group G and H belongs to subgroup H. Be any element of this group subgroup. Now GH G inverse will be equal to GH GH H inverse G inverse 2. we have given that x square belongs to h. Therefore, gh, because h inverse is equal to identity element, and gg inverse, this can be written as gh inverse will be equal to g inverse. This h inverse will be equal to identity element g inverse. This will be equal to g inverse. This is again identity element, therefore this will be equal to g inverse. This element g inverse can be written as in this form. Now gh into gh is equal to gh inverse h inverse g inverse g inverse into g inverse. This belongs to element h because x square belongs to h. Any element of this type belongs to h. Therefore, gh square h inverse g inverse belongs to h. For gh element of g, gh also belongs to g from the closure property. If gh belongs to g, this means according to the given statement x square, that is gh square, also belongs to h. Also g inverse belongs to g inverse square also belongs to also h inverse belongs to h. This means this element belongs to h. This element is equal to g inverse. This means g inverse belongs to h. Therefore h is a normal subgroup. Now what are quotient groups? A group from the given group, which is known as a quotient factor, a quotient group or residue group, we can construct a residue group or normal group, factor group or quotient group from the normal subgroup. Suppose that H be a normal subgroup of G, then the set G by H of all right cosets of H and G form a group under the composition. This H by G is a quotient group or residue class group or factor group. This quotient group, which is a group of which is a set of all right cosets of H and G. Quotient group is a set of all right cosets of H in G. This forms a group under the composition defined by H into HB is equal to HA. Quotient group is a, because quotient group is a set of all right cosets of H in G, and we have given that H is a normal subgroup, and this quotient group is set of all right cosets of H and G. Therefore, quotient group contains all the elements of this type HA, where H is right coset of H in G, H and G. This means this quotient group contains the elements of this type HA, HB, HC, and so on. Now we have to prove that this quotient group forms a group, will be a group under the composition defined by HA into HB is equal to HAB. Now we first prove that this composition is well defined. Let us suppose that H is equal to HC and HB is equal to HD for some C, D elements of G. H is equal to HC, this means from the definition of subgroup, AC inverse belongs to H. that is AC inverse will be of the type H1, where H1 is an element of H. This means A is equal to H1C. Therefore, H is equal to HC means A is equal to H1C. Similarly, HB is equal to HD means B is equal to H2D, where H1 and H2 are elements of subgroup H. This means the composition in the quotient group will be well defined if HA into HB is equal to HC into HD. That is, if HAB is equal to HCD. That is, if AB CD inverse belongs to H. Now we check that this AB into CD inverse belongs to H or not. AB into CD inverse will be equal to, by putting the value of A is equal to H1C, and that of value of B is equal to H2D. By applying the reversal law, D inverse C inverse, by associative law, H1C H2D, D inverse C, H1C H2D, again applying associative law, D inverse C inverse, H1C H2, again applying associative law, DD inverse into C inverse. This DD inverse will be equal to identity element E, H1C H2 E C1. This will be equal to H1C H2 C inverse. Again applying associative law, H1C H2 C inverse. Because H is a normal subgroup, therefore this belongs to H, and suppose that this is an element of the type H3. This will be equal to H1H3 again, because H is a subgroup, therefore H1H3 belongs to H. This means AB CD inverse belongs to H. The composition of in quotient group is well defined. Now we prove that this quotient group forms a group under the above composition. Let HA, because the quotient group is set of right cosets of H and G. HA, HB, HC are elements of this quotient group, so that ABC are elements of G, then closure property. HA, HB will be equal to HA into HB will be equal to HAB, because H is a normal subgroup of G. Therefore, also AB are elements of G, then AB also belongs to G from the closure property. Therefore, HAB belongs to quotient group. That implies HA into HA belongs to G by H, the quotient group. This means closure property hold in this group. Now, HA into HB into HC, this will be equal to HA HC. HAB into HC, this will be equal to HAB into C by associative law. HABC, A into BC, this will be equal to HA into HBC. Again, this will be equal to HA into HB into HC. This associative law holds good in quotient group. Existence of identity. HE belongs to this quotient group. HA, HE will be equal to HAE, will be equal to HA. Again, this will be equal to HE into HA. This means HE is the identity element of the quotient group. Existence of inverse. For all the elements of this type HA, right cosets of H and G, where A belongs to G, A inverse also belongs to G. This means HA inverse also belongs to quotient group. And again, suppose that HA into HA inverse is equal to HA inverse, which will be equal to HA, HE, where HE will be equal to H, and this can be written as HE, and can be written as HA inverse A. Again, this HA inverse A will be equal to HA inverse HA. That is, HA inverse is equal to HA inverse HA. This means inverse of HA belongs to quotient group. This means this quotient group forms a group.
We have already studied the definition of quotient group or factor group or residue class. If H is a normal subgroup of G, then the quotient group is this right set of all right coset of H in G under the composition H HV is called a quotient group or a factor group. Now see this theorem. If H is a subgroup of an abelian group G, then the group quotient group of all right cosets of H in G forms an abelian group under the composition defined by H HB. If H is a subgroup of an abelian group G, then H is a normal subgroup of G. This means quotient forms this forms a quotient group. Let H A HB belongs to this quotient group. So that AB are elements of G, then HA into HB is equal to HAB is equal to HBA. Because G is a abelian group, therefore AB is equal to BA for every element AB of G. This means this will be equal to HBA into HA. This means this quotient group is also an abelian group. So thank you students. These are some theorems on the normal subgroup and quotient group. Next, we will continue with some more examples. Thank you, students.